And we are demonstrating today. On the June 3rd, 2019, the military council and the Janjaweed militias in Sudan attacked and dispersed the peaceful sitting in Khartoum, the capital city. In the process of doing so, they committed a massacre that has left more than 100 dead and hundreds of wounded. They dumped bodies in the River Nile, burned down the tents at the city, attacked hospitals and doctors treating the injured. Red protesters shot and killed those who were defending the barricades and many other innocent people, including children. On the same day, cities in other cities like Anhud in Darfur, in Kordofan, were brutally dispersed in the week's prayer. Cities and protests in various cities in Darfur were also attacked and many peaceful freedom fighters were killed and injured. But the Sudanese heroes continue to stand strong. 8 months after the revolution began, the military and militias campaign of terror continue as we write this. Since June 3rd massacre, the revolutionaries in Sudan, mostly young working class women and men, have organized a massive civil disobedience campaign, which has paralyzed the country. They have put up barricades in many streets and continue to resist. But they also continue to be targeted, killed, detained, and raped. They need us to stand with them in their non-violence, courageous demands for freedom, peace, and justice. Their victory will be a victory for all those oppressed in the region and the world. What our demands are? We demand that the international community imposes full sanctions from the Sudanese military council that is ruling the country illegitimately and through the means of terror. We demand that EU and Germany stop funding cooperation in the country until the military hands over power to a civilian administration. Through the Khartoum deal with Europe signed in 2015, millions of euros have fallen into the hands of military and militias who serve Europe's agenda of terrorizing migrants from the region to prevent them from ever reaching European shores. We raise our voices loudly to denounce the inhuman treatment of migrants too. We demand that US stop its duplicity, issuing warning statements to the military council on one hand and making billion-dollar weapons deals with Sudanese military backers on the other. The same backers are committing war crimes against civilians in Yemen, which also raise our voices loudly to denounce. The same countries now presenting themselves as mediators continue to sustain the terror in Sudan with their dirty deals and their refusal to act. Thank you very much.